So it looks like your solar energy system isn't communicating. That can be frustrating. In this video, we'll show you how to troubleshoot your SolarEdge solar energy system. First, we'll make sure your outdoor devices are activated properly. Second, we'll troubleshoot the gateway device. Third, we'll make sure your internet router is working properly. If your solar energy system uses an inverter other than SolarEdge, we should have another video for you on our channel. With all that said, let's get to it. Step one, find your AC disconnect. It'll look like this. The lever on the side should be pulled up. If it's not, take care of that now. Step two, look for your home's breaker box. It'll be outside near the AC disconnect or inside your home in a place like the garage or the utility room. Make sure the breakers labeled solar are switched to the on position. Step three, make sure your inverter is turned on. You do that by making sure this circular switch is flipped to the on position. Then there will be a little red switch hidden here. Make sure it's flipped to the one position. When they're both flipped on, the screen should light up. Use the hidden green toggle switch to scroll through the different screens until you see the screen with SOK on display. Still with us? You're doing great. The next step is to check on the gateway. This is the little white device that connects your solar panel system to the internet. It should be inside your home near the internet router. On the side of your gateway, you'll notice a row of tiny LED lights. Check out the top one. This little green light is called the SOK light, and it indicates whether or not your solar panel system is connected to the internet. If the link light isn't blinking at least every 5 seconds, it's not communicating with the inverter. Time to get it back online. Follow these steps and you should be fine. Unplug the gateway from the outlet and disconnect the Ethernet cable. Unscrew the antenna from the gateway. Plug the gateway into a power source as close to the inverter as possible, preferably within line of sight. Hold down the red configuration button until all 5 lights are illuminated and solid, then let go. All 5 lights should blink for at least 15 seconds, but no longer than 3 minutes. On rare occasions, it can take up to 5 minutes. After the blinking stops, all 5 lights should extinguish. At this point, the link light should blink every 5 seconds. This means the gateway is communicating with the inverter again. Unplug the gateway and go back to the outlet where it was plugged in originally. Plug in the Ethernet cable, then plug the gateway back into the wall outlet. Make sure it's in a wall outlet and not a power strip. It should remain paired with your inverter. Still having issues? Try this one. Check the top light. It should be solid green. If not, follow these steps. Make sure the Ethernet cable is plugged in tight. It should click when it's plugged in all the way. Make sure it's plugged in tight on both the gateway and the internet router. Is your internet router working? Your router should be illuminated with lights if working properly. If it's not working, unplug the power cable from the router, wait 30 seconds, then plug it back in. After a minute, lights should illuminate. If the internet router is working properly, the Ethernet cable is secure on both ends, and you're still not getting a signal, your internet service provider might be blocking the gateway. Give your internet service provider a call. If this still doesn't work, call one of our support specialists. They'll schedule a service appointment for you.